I want to let Michael respond to the notion that they should not be allowed, whether it's Breaking the Silence or other groups that are critical of the Israeli military. Why shouldn't they be allowed into Israeli schools to open up debate?
Critical about the Israeli army is okay, but much more than critical, they're defaming the Israeli army in the world.
You'll have a chance to respond.
Spreading false information, all those organizations, and they have a political goal. It was said here, the political goal is to endanger the Israeli country, to get a political goal, and defaming the Israeli soldiers is a tool in their arsenal. That's why the law is first step in the right direction, but to my opinion, it is much too mild. And if this law will not enable to close the way from them to poison the Israeli children, and they will be yet, even if the law exists, as my partner said, the law must be very soon corrected in order to make it a better law that will really prevent people like that to enter the schools and other places, not only schools.
I have to say something that is, to be very clear here, our target is not the army, like you said or you said. Our target is the policy of continuing the occupation. We are part of the army. We believe that the army is being used for a purpose that is not defending the country. It's expanding the occupation, defending settlements, which almost every, I think, sane military general would say are hurting Israel's security. So this is a much bigger issue. And about poisoning kids or poisoning the Israeli students, we're talking about their future. Those kids in about a year after gonna do the things that I did in the army. Doesn't they deserve the small decency to know what they're about to do?